Lek and Greg Vegan Camp, the 1st of August 2021. Let's repeat the morning ritual. You wake up, you drink some water, you wait half an hour, then you brush your teeth. Then you drink some more water after you brush your teeth. When you brush your teeth, you're just disrupting what's going on in your mouth. So if you brush your teeth just right after you eat breakfast or before you eat breakfast and then do something else in your mouth, the disruption in your mouth may damage your teeth and everything in your mouth more than it benefits. So I like to wait before I brush my teeth. After the night, you need to like restore your saturation of like with the water, because you're maybe a little bit dehydrated after 8 hours, 10 hours, 12 hours of sleep. Your body is constantly using water when you breathe. You breathe out CO2. It contains your body is an engine. So it uses water all the time. So that's why you feel like you need to drink some water in the morning. Most people do. After you brush your teeth, you drink water again just to restore everything, and then you wait before you do anything else. So after a half an hour after you brush your teeth, you can just start eating something if you like, or you can wait if you're not hungry. I like to, because I'm going out to cut some weeds with the brush cutter, weed cutter, then I need to be like extra hydrated. I cannot like just do what my body feels, because I will go in the fields for 2 hours or so and I will be completely dehydrated when I come back, because I will sweat a lot. So I need to like do something unnatural now and kill a mosquito, because they are vampires. Vampires that want to suck my blood and inject me with all kinds of vaccines. And I don't want that. I will hydrate extra with lime water, because I like lime water, actually. Lime water is very nice, and we have a lot of lime. If you look at the lime tree over here, and we have on the new land also, there's a lime tree, and there's like a ton of lime, and we are not able to use it or eat it, so it's mostly compost. That is the lime tree, and you can see on the ground how it looks. And there's still a lot of lime and passion fruit coming up. And this morning I already threw some away, but look, this is bad lout, so we will just throw this into the compost. But yeah, I mean, this basket was full of lime and impossible to use. A glass of lime, and then I'll put water in and I'll just drink it. Very nice. Like, made some improvements in the kitchen area. There is like a new bed for Naruto, the black dog, because Naruto is naughty and Naruto is brave also at the same time. Like, work hard with these bricks and made a new kitchen area, nice and tidy. And while we're at the improvements, the bathroom has a new wall, bamboo wall. In the past, people were a little bit afraid of using our bathroom, because you could see from the outside, because the wall wasn't completely. But now it's a little bit dark in here, but we have light. After the lime, I will just eat these three bananas. They are like completely overripe, but I don't want to throw everything into the compost. We just cut off the bad parts. Really nice, just to keep me going while cutting the grass. Socks and boots for protection. And I have my safety glasses, my cycling t-shirt and long sleeves thing, and earplugs. And that's my setup, long pants and boots and socks. Can get a bit hot and sweaty, but we like it. Good exercise. When you pick up bricks from the ground, you can see that they're like earthworms underneath, so very wet and very very healthy soil. So the hardest thing is to not cut stuff that we still want, so everything is growing like together. So sometimes it's
by accident some good plants are being cut, which is not so good. We need to be careful.
Avocado tree!
We don't have buckets of passion fruit, but there are so many passion fruit that we are not able to eat them by ourselves. Guava filled with worms already. Lime, anyone? Seriously, a lot of lime. And we have another lime tree, and we have many lime trees, but now it's just like lime everywhere for the wind. Manao, pan!
After cutting grass, you're hungry, and after eating 100 bananas, it's nice with another lime, water, and yeah, it's probably super bad food combining, but like the super sweet bananas, it's nice to just have something sour. Nothing better than bananas from the garden and lime from the garden. This is just good.
After eating 100 bananas, there's a lot of compost. We don't have food waste here, we have compost. When I was cutting the grass, I stumbled upon this pineapple. It was just fell off this plant. So normally the pineapple is here. This is the first time I see a plant drop pineapple. So I will just leave it for one day like this, so the sugar will go down to the top, because the sugar is in the bottom right now, because it grows like this. And then if you put it like that, sometimes you see pineapple sellers have stored their pineapples like this, so the sweetness is distributed in the pineapple from the super sweet bottom to the super sour top. And here we have another pineapple, and it's already normally they're growing, I mean, they're growing like this when they're healthy, maybe, or, and sometimes they just like do like that, maybe because it's ripening up. But the good thing, if it does like this, that the sugar from the bottom will automatically go to the top. So very, I've seen this a couple of times, but never dropped from the plant itself. It's super longan season, and you can see the neighbors have picked the longan. I still have longan on the trees. I've been eating longan for every day for a month now or so. And then we have the beans coming up here. See, I've been cutting the weeds or the grass around here. When you're growing organically, the way you can see that the area is organic is that some trees will not have fruit. For example, these trees, longan trees over here, and this one over here, they don't have any fruit. And the fruit is not evenly distributed. So for example, here we have some longan, but other branches are not so much longan.
If you check out some of my older videos where I'm picking longan in an industrial area, you use a lot of stuff to force flowering, then the fruit will be much more even and much bigger. And that's because the bigger the fruit is, the more money you get for the fruit. So it's not about organic stuff here right now. It's more about quantity and the size.
So here's the compost area. I just throw the compost. The fruit scraps and banana skins and old bananas and rotten bananas. Leave them here and then put some straw on top. And then you'll have, after a while, beautiful soil that you can use to grow all kinds of nice plants. And in the fruit scraps, we also have mangoes. Mango seeds. So here's a mango seed growing in the compost. a nice mango tree. And also here we have a mango tree coming up from the compost. Whoa, one of the last tree drop mangoes, I think, for the season. And we have August, so we have had since May, June, July, August. So May, June, July, and a little bit of August. So full 3 months of mangoes on the trees. And these are mangoes you can eat. So we have been eating mangoes for full 3 months. It's amazing. And we have two big freezers full of mangoes. It's crazy. When you don't have a ladder, you have a compost bucket. And here's the view from the outer part of the garden. So not many mangoes left, maybe a couple. The outer border with the banana palms. No, banana palms are not palms, but it's banana plants, it's grass. So it's very wrong for me to say it's a banana palm. So every time I've said banana palm, I'm very, very sorry. As you can see, it's hard to keep up with the electric lawnmower. You need to take the big machines. Because when it's wet, it's really hard with the electric lawnmower. The weeds or the grass grows really, really fast, as you can imagine. Because it's warm and there's water and there's sunshine and the plants just love everything. They just use the sunshine to produce sugars and put into the soil and share with the bacteria, and the bacteria will poo, and then there will be even more nutrients for the plants, and then everything grows like insanely nicely. So happy days in the rainy season. It finally came and it's like really, really wet. So you just need to say, oh, this is a dry, wet season. And then something happens and it's very wet everywhere. A lot of mosquitoes. Poof. And this is why I enjoy to do things in the garden in the middle of the day, because when the sun is strong, the mosquitoes, they don't like the strong sun. They will dry out and die instantly. Here's the watermelon. And comparing to the mango, it's now the watermelon is bigger than the mango. Wow! My problem is that I don't know when to pick it, but I guess when it starts to wither the stem here, then I think it's ready to be picked. But I don't know. I'm also scared that the bugs will eat it. Yeah, I had a dream. I was standing here on the rice straw and looking around. And then there was like a big snake, like a Naruto snake, fleeing from a bigger snake. There was a big snake chasing a small snake. But this was only in my dream. And then there was a tiger chasing the big snake. And after the tiger, there was a lion or a big tiger chasing the smaller tiger. So it was like a chain of dragon fighting animals chasing each other. So they were chasing each other. And maybe that was just my brain that is just doing some stuff and putting data together. But yeah, if there are any dream analyzers, please let me know what it means. Snake chasing another snake, and then the bigger snake is like a chain of chasing animals. Crazy stuff, I know. Brains are strange. These longan lamiai on this tree have been really good. Yeah, I forgot the mango, so I needed to run after it and forgot to pick it up. That's why I'm breathing heavily. I gave mom the last mango, so I'm crying inside, but that's the best to do. If she wants to eat fruit, that's good. Sawadee krap kun mae, kapung krap. And here are longan, lamiai, that will be used to do an experiment. We will be experimenting when making a longan wine. Passion fruit chilling. Even though we don't have namdok mai on the trees anymore, but we have these. This is a different type. I think we have three types. This is the one type, and then there is a little bigger type that looks like this also. So this is very nice to have the... Oh, there are a lot of ants. But it's very nice to have these mangoes growing, because there are different types and then they ripen at different times. So I recommend to have different types of the same fruit, because the ripening stage will probably be different times, which maximizes the food security.
And who doesn't love food security?
So what I do when I empty the bags is I hang them on the tree, some of them, and then the rain will wash them automatically, and then I will pick them later in the dry season. And this is like a tree dropped. I mean, this area, this part is not good, but this part over here, look at how orange it is inside, and it's just super good. I will just cut away the bad parts and just eat this one. It's very nice. And it also Noina season, the nut custard apple. And these are really nice. These come from Kunme's house. We also have a couple of trees, in addition to bananas and passion fruit and lime and mangoes. Very long time since I had a good papaya. I think the papaya will be coming in a couple of months, but right now it's like no papayas. I mean, I don't know, too wet in the wet season or something. And longans, so many longans. I just want to talk, I've been experimenting with the cotton mosquito net. And cotton mosquito nets, they're just like the best. It's much easier to wash them and they don't break as easily as the plastic ones. And if they break a little bit, like if a dog bites it or something or steps on it, you can easily sew it together again, or glue and sew it together. It's just worth the investment to have a very, very good cotton mosquito net. I would recommend it to anyone.